Ruger single six. Six shot, 22 revolver. Let's check them out. Ruger single six. These single action, six shot revolvers were produced by Ruger in June 1953, and they're still made production today. What we have here is two versions of the convertible single six, single action, 5.5 inch barrel. We have a stainless steel, all stainless steel construction, rosewood grip ones. They have, both of these guns are unloaded, we'll show you. These are the new model single sixes where the cylinder will rotate once the loading gate is opened up. They have micro-adjustable rear sights, black front target sights, black on black. The blue version has an aluminum frame. It's a little bit lighter, blued steel barrel. Same mechanism, six shot, convertible, 22 long rifle barrel or cylinders that we have in now. They also come with 22 Winchester Magnum cylinders, so you can convert for like hunting or a little bit heavier target shooting. Micro adjustable sights, ramped front sight. These guns have been in production for over 60 years, still going strong. Produced by Ruger, and reminiscent of the single action army revolvers made by Colt back in the old West days in the 1870s. And today, these are the new model ones. They have a transfer bar safety, which means that the gun is safe to carry with six rounds. The firearm will only fire once the trigger is pulled, and the transfer bar will allow the hammer to hit the firing pin. These are made today in higher capacities, 9-shot, 10-shot. They have fiber optic sights, lots of different configurations, but we went with the traditional 6-shot Western style revolver. Both of these have 5.5-inch barrels. You can get them with different barrel lengths. I think even all the way up to like maybe 12 inches. I don't know if Ruger still produces that today, but they have made those in the past. Very accurate guns, very fun guns to shoot. Single action. Very accurate and great for plinking, for hunting. Just an American icon, have been around for over 60 years. Back in the 1950s, Colt kind of shied away from producing the single action revolvers for a while. Ruger took that market and really went, had home run hits with that. Really went to town, and these have been a staple of American shooting ever since. So we're gonna do a little bit of shooting. We're shooting the 22 long rifle cylinders in both of these today. And then we'll come back. Okay, we're gonna just do a little quick demonstration on how to disassemble and either swap out the cylinders or for cleaning purposes with the single sixes. First and foremost, open the gate, make sure gun is empty, no ammunition in the chambers. You wanna have the opening gate open. There's a little pin on cross pin on the side here. You push it from the left side to the right. As you do that, grab a hold of the cylinder rod, pull that out, and then your cylinder comes out from the right side. Then your gun is disassembled. You can do your cleaning inside the frame. Again, this is the 22 long rifle cylinder. The 22 long rifle cylinders have fluting on the cylinder. The 22 magnums are solid, and they're going to be marked. Should be marked on here. the 22 Winchester Magnum is marked for that, but the 22 long rifle is not marked, but it has the flutings on there. Another thing about the Ruger single sixes, if you're ever in a gun shop and you're looking maybe at a used one, thinking about purchasing it, these cylinders are numbered to the gun, and that's based on the timing for the cylinder. So you want to make sure there's going to be three digits here, three numerical digits on the front of the cylinder face, and that's going to be matched to the serial number on the gun. So it's three digits, should be matching the last digits on the gun. So again, if you're ever in the market of buying a used one, you want to make sure that the cylinder digits on there match the gun, or else it may not be timed, because these are timed from the factory to match that. So reassembly is basically the same in reverse. You're going to keep your loading gate open. Cylinder is going to go in from the right side to the left. You just put it in through here. And then you're going to want to align the cylinder so the fluting is even on both sides. You take your cylinder rod, this is going to go in from the front, and make sure that the pinned, the part with the little tip on it, is facing the rear of the gun. Align that up, and you can push the pin, the cross pin over, and that should slide right in. Release the cross pin, that's going to lock it in. Gun is reassembled and ready to go. This is going to be the same process for the 22 Winchester Magnum cylinder that comes with the convertible ones. If you buy those, you're going to get two cylinders, and you can swap them out that easy. And very, very efficient, very easy way to clean and swap out cylinders. So we're going to do a little bit more shooting. Okay, and we're going to do a little shooting with 22 long rifle. Again, these are the Ruger new model single sixes. The old ones, originally made before 1973 when they put in the transfer bars, were probably not the most safest to carry with six rounds in the cylinder. You'd want to have an empty chamber underneath the hammer, because they didn't have a transfer bar, and potentially strike of the hammer could set off a round. They were considered the three screw ones. Now they use pins and stuff, built very well, probably a lot safer than the old ones. But the old single sixes were, before the 1973, had the traditional Colt cocking mechanism, where you had to have it on half cock to be able to open the loading gate to load the rounds. Now the new single sixes, you just open the loading gate, that releases the cylinder to be able to spin. So again, these are single action, one round at a time. Pretty cold out here today. It's about 18 degrees, the Friday before deer season, 2018. There you can see, got six rounds in the cylinder. Close the loading gate, and we're ready to go. This is a single action revolver, so one shot at a time. We're going to do a little bit of shooting. I'll shoot at the right target, probably upper right corner, and see how we do. Okay, then to unload, open the loading gate. You have your extractor rod on the side of the barrel. Rotate the cylinder to where the extractor rod, you can see it poking through there. We'll fit the cylinder chamber, and then you just push out your shells one by one. old school, but so relevant today. A lot of fun to shoot. Check your chambers, clear, close the loading gate, and we're safe to reload again.
So this is the aluminum frame blued. I'm gonna be loading 6 shots up in it and shooting at the target. Now, a lot of people use these for competitions. They have single action shooting sports, actually. They every year they have a big one up in Nevada. Take a couple shots. Like you said, to unload it, you just push the shells out with the
ejector rod.
Make sure that's empty, and you can load it up again.
Okay, well, thank you for watching Ruger Single Six from the Two Lucky Gunners. As always, enjoy your firearms, stay safe, and shoot well. Thanks.